Hello everyone, I welcome you all to this second session on fluid dynamics. Now coming to overview of this session, first we will discuss some general equations which are required to solve problems on Bernoulli's equation. Then we will see Bernoulli's equation. Then we will solve few problems on Bernoulli's equation. In the last class, we have discussed a few problems on Bernoulli's equation. We will continue few more problems here. These are the important equations which are required to solve problems on Bernoulli's equation. First equation is discharge, that is volumetric flow rate. SI unit is meter cube per second. Notation is Q, that is area into velocity. This equation is also called continuity equation. A into area into velocity. At inlet it is A1V1, at outlet A2V2. That means at section 1 A1V1, at section 2 A2V2. So velocity at section 1 you can find out Q by A1. Similarly V2 at section 2 Q by A2. A1 and A2 are the cross sectional area of the pipe. A1 is pi D1 square by 4. D1 is the diameter at the inlet section or section 1. A2 will be the diameter pi by 4 into D square. D2 will be the diameter at the section 2. So with this equation we can solve the problems on Bernoulli's equation. So Bernoulli's equation is given by P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2. It is the Bernoulli's equation for section 1 and 2. If you apply, you will get this equation. General form of Bernoulli's equation is P by rho g plus V square by 2g plus Z is equal to constant. There P by rho g is called pressure head, V square by 2g is called kinetic head, and Z is called datum head. So if you apply this equation for section 1 and 2, the equation alters to P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2. With this, we will continue the problem number 4. The water is flowing through a pipe having diameters 20 cm and 10 cm at a section 1 and 2 respectively. The rate of flow through pipe is 35 liters per second. The section 1 is 6 meters above the datum and section 2 is 4 meters above the datum. If the pressure at a section 1 is 39.24 Newton per centimeter square, find the intensity of pressure at section 2. So by looking at this problem statement, the diameters at section 1 and 2 is mentioned, that is 20 cm and 10 cm at section 1 and 2 respectively. So first you need to convert the given data into proper SI unit. So diameter at section 1 is 20 cm, that is converted into meter, that is 0.2 meter. So area 1. Section at section 1 is A1, that is pi by 4 into d square, that is 0.0314 meter square. Similarly, pressure is given at section 1, that is 39.24 Newton per centimeter square. You have to convert Newton per centimeter square to Newton per meter square, because pressure P1 should be in terms of Pascal, that is Newton per meter square. If you multiply into 10 to the power of 4, you will get in terms of Newton per meter square. So Z1 is given 6 meter. At section 2, diameter is given 0.10 meter. It is given in terms of 10 centimeter. It is converted into meter, 0.10 meter. Similarly, area A2 and Z2 is given 4 meter. This diagram you need to draw by looking at all the given data. Okay, transfer into diagram. So it is clearly mentioned the diameters of section 1 and 2, that is 20 centimeter and 10 centimeter at section 1 and 2, and the section 1 which is at a height of 6 meter and section 2 which is at a height of 4 meter. This information is given. So by looking at that, the tapered pipe diagram you have to draw. Datum line means reference line. Okay. Now what we have to find out? Find the intensity of pressure at section 2. That is P2 we have to find out. Okay. So with the help of continuity equation, Q is equal to area into velocity, we can find out velocity V1 and V2. Then we have to apply the Bernoulli's equation at section 1 and 2, and we have to solve for pressure at section 2. So first you find with the help of continuity equation velocity 1 at 1 and 2. So one more information, it is given in terms of 35 liters per second. Normally the discharge or volumetric flow rate will be given in terms of liters per second. That you have to convert it into meter cube per second, because all other parameters in terms of meter, that is why liters per second to meter cube per second you have to convert by multiply 10 to the power of minus 3 or divided by 1000, that is 0.035 meter cube per second. So now looking at the continuity equation, find out V1 and V2. First apply the section 1, Q is equal to A1 V1, find out V1 with the help of that. That is 1.114 meter per second. Similarly, go for V2. At section 2, if you apply A2 into V2 equal to this same Q, so you will get 4.456 meter per second. Now you have the value of pressure head, velocity head, Z1, velocity head at section 2 and Z2. Only P2 is unknown here. That is pressure, intensity of pressure at section 2. If you substitute all the values in this equation, you will get the value of P2. Remaining all values you have, just substitute in proper SI unit. 39.24 pressure at section 1. It is given in terms of Newton per centimeter square. You need to convert into Newton per meter square. That is by multiplying 10 to the power of 4. Divided by rho is, density. Liquid is not mentioned. If it is mentioned, you have to take respective liquid density. Here, water is mentioned here. Sorry. So water is mentioned. So water density under standard atmospheric condition is 1000 into 9.81 gravity value. Similarly, V1 square by 2G. V1 value you have 2 into G gravity plus Z1 is datum head. That is 6. Similarly, equal to P2 by rho G plus V2 square by 2G plus 4. Here only P2 is unknown. If you solve, you will get 40.27 Newton per centimeter square. First you will given in terms of whatever the solution from this equation you will get in terms of Newton per meter square, that you can convert into Newton per centimeter square, or else you can keep in Newton per meter square also. Now we will move to next problem, that is problem number 5. Water is flowing through a pipe having diameter 300 mm and 200 mm at the bottom and upper end respectively. The intensity of pressure at the bottom end is 24.525 Newton per centimeter square, and the pressure at the upper end is 9.81 Newton per centimeter square. Determine the difference in datum head if the rate of flow through pipe is 40 liters per second. So we have to find out, determine the difference in datum head. What is the meaning of datum head? That is nothing but Z1 and Z2. Difference means Z2 minus Z1 we have to find out. If you observe the statement of this problem, the diameter given in terms of mm, that you have to convert into meter. Then intensity of pressure, that is given in terms of Newton per meter centimeter square, that you have to convert into Newton per meter square. Then pressure at the upper side, it is given in terms of Newton per centimeter square, that also you have to convert into Newton per meter square. In the solution part, while writing the given data, first you need to convert the given data into a respective SI unit. Now if you look at the diagram of this problem, by looking at this problem statement. Diameter is 300 mm and 200 mm at the bottom and upper end respectively. This information is given, so you can easily draw this diagram. Okay, Z1 and Z2. Okay, whatever the diameter is given, 300 mm is and 200 mm, that you can take it as section 1 and 2, because in this problem, which diameter having which section not mentioned, so that is why you can take any section as 1 and 2, which having diameter 300 mm is the first diameter they have mentioned, that is why by default they have taken section 1, and 200 mm is the second diameter they have given, that is why they have taken at section 2. The intensity of pressure at the bottom, that is given here, 24.525, and intensity of the pressure at the upper end, that is 9.81. So whatever the information given, okay, that you have transformed into diagram. So diameter at section 1 is given, D2 is given, pressure P1 is given, P2 is given, that you have to convert into proper SI unit. Next, continuity equation, Q is equal to area into velocity, okay. Then one more thing, Q is given in terms of 40 liters per second, you need to convert into meter cube per second, that is 0.04 meter cube per second. The volumetric flow rate or discharge given in terms of liters per second, that you have to convert into meter cube per second by dividing 1000. Now with the help of continuity equation, A1V1 equal to A2V2, that is equal to 0.04. With the help of that, you can find out V1 and V2. Similar steps we have followed in the last problem. Okay, V1 is equal to 0.5658 meter per second and V2 as 1.274 meter per second. Now we will apply the Bernoulli's equation at section 1 and 2. P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2. This is the part of Bernoulli's equation at section 1. This is the part of the Bernoulli's equation at section 2. Now Z1 and Z2 only unknown, remaining all are known values. We need the value of Z2 minus Z1, that is a difference in datum head, that is nothing but 13.70 meter you will get. Substitute all the parameters in proper SI unit, then you will get Z2 minus Z1 as 13.70 meter. Now we will see the sixth problem. A 200 meter long pipe has a slope of 1 in 100 and tapers from 1 meter diameter at the high end to 0.5 meter diameter at the low end. If the quantity of water flowing through the pipe is 80 liters per second and the pressure at the high end is 70 kilopascal, then determine the pressure at the lower end. Assume that datum passes through the lower end and the neglect the losses. So length is given, 200 meter long pipe, that is the length of the pipe, and has a slope of 1 in 100, okay, 1 in 100, and tapers from 1 meter diameter at the high end and 0.5 meter diameter at the low end, that is larger diameter at the high end, smaller diameter at the low end. Then one more information given, lower end datum passes through the lower end, that means the lower end of the pipe is passes through the datum line, that means Z2 value is 0. There is no elevation from the datum line to the section 2. If please observe this sentence, assume that datum passes through the lower end of the pipe, that is Z2. There is no height here from section 2 to datum line, that is why datum head at section 2 is 0, that you have to consider. Now Z1 value, they have given Z1 is 1 in 100 of 200 meter long. How much taper it is? Slope of 1 in 100. 1 in 100 of what? 200 meter. That is Z1 value. Z1 is equal to 1 by 100 into 200. Taper value given, 1 in 100. How much long? 200 meter long. So z1 value you can calculate by 200 into 1 by 100. Now other data, if you look at the discharge is given 80 liters per second, that you have to convert into meter cube per second by dividing 1000. Then P1 70 kilopascal, Z2 is 0 as we discussed right now, datum passes through the lower end. Then area A1 and A2, similar method V1 V2 by the continuity equation, pi D1 square by 4 as area at the inlet, that is 0.7854 meter square, and V1 Q by A1, Q is equal to A1 V1 is the equation, so 0.108 meter per second. Similarly A2, 0.19635 meter square you will get, and V2 Q by A2, 0.4074 meter per second. Now we have to find out Z1 value. Since the datum line passes through the center of the lower end, Z2 value is 0, that is datum head at section 2 is 0. There is no elevation from the datum line to the lower end of the pipe. That means there is no datum head at section 2. That is why Z2 value is 0. Z1 is equal to slope of 1 in 100. 1 in 100 into what is the length? 200. That is equal to 2 meter. Now you have the value of Z1, Z2 and pressure head and kinetic head. Now you have to apply the Bernoulli's equation at section 1 and 2. That is what P1 by rho W into G. Density of fluid is water here. That is why we have considered rho W. If it is oil, respect to density you have to put rho of oil you have to substitute. So respective fluid density you have to put in the equation. Then kinetic head and datum head. Similarly, pressure head, kinetic head and datum head at section 2. So only the intensity of pressure at section 2 is unknown. Remaining all data we know. So if you substitute in proper SI unit, you will get the value of 89.542 kilopascal as intensity of pressure at section 2. Please observe here, in this problem you have to notice this Z1 value is indirectly given. Slope they have given 1 in 100. Length is given, that means 1 by 100 into length you have to do to find out Z1. Now we will see the seventh problem. The water is flowing through a taper pipe of length 100 meter having the diameter 600 mm at the upper end and 300 mm at the lower end at the rate of 50 liters per second. The pipe has slope of 1 in 30. Find the pressure at the lower end if the pressure at the higher level is 19.62 Newton per centimeter square. Again, similar to last problem, pipe has a slope of 1 in 30 given. Okay, then length of the pipe also given. Similar to last problem. So here length of the pipe 100 meter, diameter at the upper end D1 is equal to 0.6 meter. It is given in terms of mm, that you have to convert into meter. Then if you know the diameter, you can find out cross sectional area, that is pi by 4 into D1 square. That is 0.2827 meter square. Then pressure at the upper end is given 19.62 Newton per centimeter square, that you have to convert into Newton per meter square. That is 19.62 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per meter square. Similarly, diameter at the lower end 300 mm, that is 0.3 meter. Find out A2, pi by 4 into D2 square, that is 0.07068 meter. So discharge is given, Q or rate of flow or volumetric flow rate, that is 50 liters per second. You have to convert it into meter cube per second by dividing 1000. That is 0.05 meter cube per second. Let the datum line passes through the center of the lower end. Okay, in this problem, they have not mentioned about the lower end. There is no information about datum head also. There is no information about where the lower end is. That is why you have to assume, but in the last problem it is clearly mentioned, assume that datum passes through the lower end. This information is not given in this problem. Then datum head at section 2 also not mentioned. That is why it is required to assume the datum line passes through the center of the lower end. That means Z2 value is not given, you can assume it as 0. How to assume as 0? You have to assume the datum line passes through the center of the lower end. That means there is no height difference between datum line and center of this lower end. Very important point, if the Z2 value is not mentioned in the problem, slope is given in the problem, then Z2 value you have to assume it as 0, or else they have to mention this sentence: assume that datum passes through the lower end of the pipe. Now Z2 value is 0 here, slope is given 1 in 30, so we can find out Z1, 1 by 30 into 100, that is 10 by 3 meter or 3.33 meter. So now Q is equal to continuity equation A1V1 equal to A2V2, similar methods followed, V1 and V2 as 0.177 meter per second and V2 as 0.707 meter per second. Now we have the value of velocity V1, V2 and pressure P1, P2 and Z1, Z2. P2 is the unknown. Now we have to apply the Bernoulli's equation at section 1 and 2. If we apply at section 1, P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is equal to, at section 2, if you apply the Bernoulli's equation, you will get P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g is equal to plus Z2. Next, you have to substitute the pressure in terms of Newton per meter square. In order to convert into Newton per centimeter square to Newton per meter square, they have multiplied 10 to the power of 4. Remaining rho into g, rho of water into gravity, and V1 square by 2g, Z1 10 by 3. And P2 by rho g, P2 is unknown, okay. And V2 square by 2g plus Z2. Here you can substitute rho as 1000 and gravity as 9.81, okay. Finally, if you substitute all the values in proper SI unit, you will get the answer as 22.857 Newton per centimeter square. After the calculation, you will get this value, that is in terms of Newton per meter square. If you want to convert it into Newton per centimeter square, you can convert. If you are, you can keep in Newton per meter square also, no issues. So we have solved 7 problems on Bernoulli's equation. With this, I am concluding this session. The following references are used for my preparation. Thank you.